Good morning, students. Happy New Year to all of you. Welcome in the new session with the live classes. As you all know, that we are going to start the live classes. Newton Standard students have completed the first or I think two pages of this chapter which we are going to study though, but the CLAM section is not started. So we'll start it from very beginning. Right, everyone? So let's see the information of the lecture first. Class 9, subject English, and the book behind we are reading. This is chapter number 9. Lesson number 9, The Bond of Love by Kenneth Anderson. And this is lecture number 1, students. So let's start from very beginning because of technical problem, we have very less time. It's the first day today. So let's just start from very beginning. The chapter we are going to study today is about an animal. In that, before you read, the author, Kenneth Anderson, has given us a sort of a glimpse of the chapter that we are going to read so that we can understand what will we read in the text. What author talks about, can there be love and friendship between human beings and wild animals? See, this is the question quoted by the narrator, students. Narrator or the author talking to us or asking to us like, can there be love and friendship between human beings and wild animals? Well, of course, it's a very difficult question to justify because it varies from person to person or animal to animal. Some are very wild, even the human beings also. Well, definitely animals are wild, right? But some are really very amicable, we can say. We can say friendly. So the author is asking, can there be love and friendship? Well, of course, students, there can be. Probability is there. It depends person to person. So what we are going to see, let's read a fascinating account of an orphaned sloth whale that was rescued by the author. The one who has presented this as talking to us, saying us, let's read. Now we are going to read a fascinating underline, a fascinating word, students, which means extremely interested and attractive. Means attractive thing, that's what we are going to read. Account of an orphaned sloth whale. Sloth means living in trees or in tropical parts of the America, basically. That's the animals, that type of animals which live in trees or in the forested areas. That's called sloth. And we are going to read about the bear. That's a bhalu that was rescued by the author. Author rescued this bear. And about this, we are going to read. Now, the narrator provides us the information about the sloth bears inhabit forested areas. Inhabit means they maximum live in the forested areas, including the tropical rainforests where the rain falls. That's in India and grasslands at lower elevations. The lower elevations refers to the lower parts of the country, basically, or in the forests. The sloth bears have very shaggy hair and long muscles. You must have seen the picture before you that the hair style of the bear are very shaggy. That's called like very rough type of hair they have, and long muscles. Muscles refers to like the nose and mouth of an animal. You see the nose and mouth, the outward appearance of nose and mouth is very typical, very different. That's called muscle. So it's muscles, like the narrator is explaining or like making us a bit familiar about the bear. Using their claws to dig, and they have got the claws, jinko hum log panje bolte hain, they use them to claws to dig. Dig means to like making a sort of a hole in the earth or the soil. They can then use their lips to form a tube, and they can use like their lips to form a tube for like they are going to get any sort of work to be done, they can make it. Like this is their actual habit, or like they make it happen, things like this, which can go deep into the ground. Deep into the ground refers to like when they dig any sort of ground in the holes, or like they can push their lips. You can see the face of the bear that can go into the deep ground and hard to reach areas like dead trees and their food. The bear basically eat the dead trees or the termites. Their main food is termites. Termites basically refer to like the small insects which are found in the dead trees. Students, now you can hear them suck up their food from several feet away. What does it mean by from the several feet away? Means they, like the bear, they can suck. They can smell very well properly, and they can suck their food from very far because of their lips or because of their tongue. Now, it was a small information about the sloth bear, students. Now, let's start it from very beginning. The story we are going to read about it, we have a little bit idea, like what sort of animals are they, their habits, their living, and sort of things basically, right? So now, what will we see? We'll read it out. The narrator says to us, I will begin with Bruno, my wife's pet sloth bear. Pet means like paltu, jisko hum bolte hain, having at home like a family member. So hamara narrator kya batata hai, I will begin with Bruno. Bruno ke bare mein wo batate hain hame, I got him for her by accident. By accident refers to like all of a sudden, not decided earlier or before. So by accident jo hai unko Bruno mil jata hai. Now the story, he says, 2 years ago we were passing through the sugarcane fields near Mysore. Author batata hai ki 2 saal pehle kya hota hai, we were passing through the sugarcane, ganne ke khet se nikal kar ke wo ja rahe the near Mysore. Mysore ke paas people were driving away the wild pigs from the fields by shooting at them. You see, in the fields basically wild pigs, jungle suar jinko hum bolte hain, they come in the field and they destroy the fields, corn fields or ripe fields basically. So they, wild pigs come in the fields and just destroy this. So the people basically driving away means like they were trying to kill them, they were shooting them so that they can either run away from the fields or they should be killed by their shootings. Some were shot and some escaped. Now the narrator is saying some of the pigs or another like other animals were there, they were killed. Kuch to mar jate hain aur kuch bach karke nikal jate hain. We thought that everything was over when suddenly a black sloth bear came out panting in the hot sun. We thought, narrator is saying ki bhai humne socha that everything was over when suddenly a black sloth bear came out. Unko laga ki bhai ab sabhi chale gaye hain, lekin thodi samay baad kya hota hai, a black sloth bear, black bear came out panting means to breath quickly with short breaths, like was huffing and puffing while just running in the hot sun. Now I will not shoot a sloth bear wantonly. Wantonly means for no good reason. Till there is a good reason, narrator is not going to shoot the bear. But unfortunately for the poor beast, poor means bechara, janwar, beast hota hai janwar. Unfortunately means durbhagyavash kya hua, one of my companions did not feel that way about it. As the narrator thought about the bear, his companion, one of his companion did not think about the poor beast like the narrator was thinking. So what happened? Promptly shot the bear on the spot. Promptly refers to like all of a sudden, immediately The one shot the bear on the spot and the bear was killed. As we watched the fallen animal, we were surprised to see that the flapper of its back moved and left the prostrate body. And now what we are getting, as they were watching the fallen animal, means the animal, the bear, fell down when one of their companions shot the animal, this bear. So they got surprised. What they got surprised about, like they saw the fur. Fur is the upper part or skin of the bear that was moving actually. And after a moment, 1 or 2 minutes, or you can say a moment, they left the prostrate body. Prostrate body means the dead body basically, and started running here and there. Then we saw it was a baby bear that had been riding on its mother's back. So what they discovered, that it was the baby of the bear that had been riding on its mother's back. It was just clinged to its mother's body. And after it was dead, the baby bear started running here and there. When the sudden shot had killed her, the little creature ran around its prostrate parent, making a pitiful noise. And that sloth bear was making pitiful, means very painful, noise, and was running here and there because the mother was dead by the shot. I ran up to it to attempt a capture. The narrator is saying, like, he went to be a baby and wanted to capture it, wanted to hold it. It scooted means ran away. It ran away into the sugarcane field. Means the baby was even a bit conscious. The narrator could not catch it, could not hold it basically. And the baby ran away in the sugarcane field. Following it with my companions, I was at last able to grab it by the scruff of its neck. While it snapped and tried to scratch me with its long hooked claws. Now you see the situation, students. When the bear baby was running, it was going in the sugarcane field. The narrator and one of his companions, they chased it. They went after it to just catch it. So at last what happened, the narrator is saying, I was at last able to grab it by the scruff of its neck and that holded it. It was held by the narrator. Scruff means like it was very dirty, the neck part of that bear baby, because the hair were quite shaggy and it was covered with all dust and sort of mud basically. While it snapped and tried to scratch me with its long hooked claws, and the baby bear tried to scratch the narrator with the claws. As I told you, like, the claws of the bears are very strong. They can scratch even the earth, or they can make hole with the help of their claws. So the little baby tried to scratch the narrator. We put it in one of the gunny bags we had brought, and when I got back to Bangalore, I duly presented it to my wife. The narrator is saying, we put it in the gunny bag. Gunny bag is a sort of bag, jisko log bori bhi bol dete hain. They put that baby bear in the bag we had brought, and when I got back to Bangalore, narrator is saying, when they came back from the fields, and as they came back to Bangalore, he presented this sort of gift, or you can say the baby bear, to his wife. She was delighted. Delighted refers to like she was very happy to see the baby bear. She at once put a colored ribbon around its neck. And the lady put a ribbon around its neck. After putting the ribbon at its neck, she discovered that it was a boy, and she christened it Bruno. Bruno refers to like, when she discovered like it was a male bear, she put its name Bruno. Like this, the baby bear got its name, Bruno. After handing over this to the narrator's wife, now what happened? Bruno soon took to drinking milk from a bottle. It was but a step further, and within a very few days, he started eating and drinking everything else. Now what we get the things about the Bruno? Soon means after spending a few days with the family members, Bruno started drinking milk from the bottle. It was but a step further, and within a few days, he started eating and drinking everything else. Rest of the things were presented in the family for the animal, whether it is for drinking or like for eating, that animal became immune to. Immune to refers to like habitual for eating the things, and everything is the right word for he ate porridge made from ingredients, vegetables, fruits, nuts, meat, especially pork. These are the items were presented to him. Jaise ki porridge means hota hai students halwa, jo ki different ingredients ko mila kar ke banta tha, and curry and rice, regardless of the condiments, and chilies, bread, eggs, chocolates, sweets, pudding, ice cream, etc., etc., etc. As for drink, milk, tea, coffee, lime juice, aerated water. Aerated water means mixed water with, or like with the soil, like they drink in the forested areas where they live basically, or buttermilk, beer, alcoholic liquor, and in fact, anything liquid. These are the items, students, which are presented by the narrator. Like these all sorts of things he started eating as well as drinking, despite living with the family of the narrator. It all went down with relish. Relish refers to like his enjoying there all the things. And while enjoying all the things, it was just for him, like he was making such of things in his life. The enjoyment was very great, and it was pleasurable for him. Great enjoyment was there. Relish refers to, you can underline the word relish, means great enjoyment or pleasure. Great enjoyment or pleasure he was having despite living there with the narrator's family. So what we find, students, we have got a time limit. Let's complete the next point and then we'll have out session. Students, the bear became very attached to our two Alsatian dogs and to all the children of the tenants. Alsatian dogs the narrator was having in his family, and to all the children of the tenants. Tenants hota hai kiraida, the people are living in the narrator's home after paying the rent, that is called tenants. Living in our bungalow, he was left quite free in his younger days and spent his time in playing, running into the kitchen and going to sleep in our beds. Like the bear was given friendly environment in the family, he was free to go in the kitchen or to sleep with the narrator's family members in their beds, basically with them. And he was free to play with the children as well as with the Alsatian dogs. Alsatian dog means this is a sort of breed of the dog children. Alsatian dogs, thode height thodi achhi hoti hai. Its height is good and they are a bit heavy also. One day an accident befell him that we'll read tomorrow, students, that we need to see because it is 12:02. We have got limited time. If any one of you has any doubt, you can raise your hand, students.